Hello students, let us continue our discussion. In the last lecture we have discussed sine inverse sine x and cos inverse cos x. Okay, I asked you to work out the rest. Hope you must have done. Okay, we can verify that. Let us start with tan inverse tan x. Okay, still these are basic derivations only, but they are the backbone of this topic. Tan inverse tan x. Okay, so remember tan inverse range of tan inverse lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So as long as it lies between this interval, you can accept it as x that belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, excluding both endpoints. So what I am going to do is I am going to draw minus pi by 2 and this is plus pi by 2. Okay, so this line we will draw, what is this? Y equal to x. This meets at x equal to pi by 2. This meets at x equal to minus pi by 2. If you look at the domain of this particular function tan inverse tan x, right, that is same as domain of tan x because the input goes to tan x first. Therefore, r minus odd multiple of pi by 2. That means even at pi by 2 minus pi by 2, it is not defined. So, we are going to put a hole here just to denote that these endpoints are excluded in the graph. Okay, so that is tan inverse tan x. And if we have got this graph in the interval, what is the length of interval you see? Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, whose length is pi. And remember, suppose you call this as a function f of x. F of x is also a periodic function with same period as that of tan x, fundamental period pi. So f of x plus pi, if you see, tan inverse tan of x plus pi, that is nothing but tan inverse tan x, which is f of x. Therefore, I can say that f of x is periodic function with fundamental period, you know, pi. So once it is fundamental period and we have got the pattern in this interval, the rest of the number line, you know, we simply copy paste this, replicate this, right? So therefore, so at each of these pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, it would be excluded pi pi by 2, even at, you know, minus 3 pi by 2, etc. And it will be simply, this is excluded, okay, and again one more line. Same pattern here, starts here and excluded here, etc. So basically tan inverse tan x, as you can see, set of parallel lines. This line in question is y equal to x, which meets x axis at x equal to 0, and this is beyond 3 pi by 2, so pi will be somewhere here. So there is one more line in fact, right, that starts at pi by 2 and ends at 3 pi by 2, so passing through pi. So this is y equal to x minus pi, this is y equal to x minus 2 pi, and this one, there is again this line y equal to, okay, x plus 3 pi by 2. Okay, so these are the graphs. Okay, there is a difference of pi pi, then they must be, so sorry, this is not 3 pi by 2, right? The graph was not correct here. At 3 pi by 2, there is a hole, right? So ideally, yeah, this should be y equal to x plus pi. So the next line would be coming somewhere here and going up to here. This is y equal to x plus 2. Okay, so that is your tan inverse tan x graph, which is nothing but, you know, set of parallel lines. each at a distance of, you know, pi units, which is fundamental period of tan inverse tan x. That was very simple. Only difference is the end points are always being excluded. Okay, that is about tan inverse tan x. Next, I think it's the simplest graph. Next is the moving on. Next is f of x equal to cot inverse of cot x. Okay. So cot inverse of cot x, if you look at the domain of the function, that is same as domain of cot x. So domain of this function is same as domain of cot x, that is r minus n pi. So n pi is r excluded. Okay, and the range is nothing but range of cot inverse that lies between 0 to pi, open interval 0 to pi. So like always, f of x plus pi, as you can see, is f of x, implies f is periodic function with fundamental period equal to pi. So let us draw x-axis n pi, so this is excluded. Okay, cot inverse 0 to pi, okay, it is excluded in both the domain as well as range 0, and the pi for example is this, this is also excluded. Okay, and now this can be accepted as x as long as it lies between 0 to pi. Okay, so 0 to pi, this is pi. In the domain, even pi is excluded, so there is a hole here, even 0 is excluded. So as you can see, this is y equal to x excluding the end point 0 and pi. And that is the graph of cot inverse cot x in an interval of length pi, which is fundamental period of this function. So in the rest of the interval, we'll simply replicate the graph. So that means you're going to copy paste it, exclude these, okay, extend this until, for example, 2 pi, okay, again it starts here, ends at 3 pi, etc. So as you can see, these are nothing but similar to tan inverse tan x, set of parallel lines but slightly shifted above, right? So this is y equal to x plus pi, and then y equal to x plus 2 pi, etc. Okay, clear? Next one. Fx equal to secant inverse secant x. Fx equal to secant inverse secant x. So domain of this function is same as domain of secant x, that is like r minus odd multiples of pi by 2. And range of this function is same as range of secant inverse, which is like, you know, 0 to pi excluding pi by 2. Excluding pi by 2. So this is my favorite graph. It looks like a comic character. Lovely. Okay. So again, if you talk about the periodicity, f of x plus 2 pi, which is same as the fundamental period of, you know, secant x. So you need to draw the graph of f is periodic with period 2 pi, with fundamental period tf equal to 2 pi. So we are going to draw the graph in an interval of length 2 pi. And you can accept this as x as long as x lies between 0 to pi, of course excluding pi by 2. Let us see what to do after that. Okay, so in the domain it is present, in the range 0 is also present. What is not present is pi by 2, horizontal asymptote, we will call it. Okay, and then there is this pi, you can mark. In the domain, pi by 2 is not there. okay, minus pi by 2 minus pi. So y equal to x when x belongs to 0 to pi, 0 to pi. So this may be pi and this is 0, you simply join it. But then you see, it should not touch this particular line y equal to pi by 2. Second inverse is never equal to pi by 2 for any real number. So you exclude that and then go forward. So as we can see, this is the maximum value for the second inverse. So beyond which it has to turn down. Okay, let us see what to do with that. So we have covered an interval of 0 to pi. Once it has to come down, this is y equal to x, like we have done before. Y equal to, it must be minus x plus something, but that is another way, minus x plus lambda, you can assume the slopes are only plus 1 or minus 1, otherwise it will be like secant 2x something, that will never be equal to secant x. Secant x can be brought back by, you can write secant x as secant, for example, x minus 2 pi, for example, or secant 2 pi minus x, or secant x plus 2 pi. You can never write like secant 2x plus something. Okay, that is the idea. So anyway, it will come down, so it is minus x plus something, but you see this point is at pi, it is pi, pi comma pi. Another way to get this. So lambda equal to 2 pi, y equal to minus x plus 2 pi. So it will come down and meet at 2 pi, but again this is excluded. You get it? Okay, so alternatively when x is beyond pi, I'm simply rewriting this as y equal to 2 pi minus x. Secant inverse secant 2 pi minus x. That is secant inverse secant x. 2 pi minus x will now fit into the range of 0 to pi, excluding pi by 2. So this is the complete graph we got in an interval of length 2 pi. So that I can copy paste. So again it is like this. Say this is pi. Okay, again it will come down like this. So you see, as a square snapshot, the graph will be something like this. Okay, just like some funny character. Okay, so that is your secant inverse secant x graph. Triangular patterns with two eyes excluded points at pi by 2. Okay. So, I mean, this should be exactly pi by 2. And this is 3 pi by 2. This is minus pi by 2. This is like, you know, minus 3 pi by 2. And this center point should be minus pi. That is the perfect scale. Okay. So, that is about secant inverse secant x. Okay. Next. Last one. Cosecant inverse cosecant x. Again, if you look at domain range, etc., domain of this is same as domain of cosecant x, that is like r minus n pi, n is integer. Range of this is same as range of cosecant inverse, that is like, you know, minus pi by 2 to 0, union 0 to pi by 2. Alright, so I can accept cosecant inverse cosecant x as equal to x if x belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 excluding the element 0. Okay, and like always, yeah, it is also periodic with fundamental period 2 pi. So we try to plot the graph in an interval of length 2 pi and then we'll try to replicate it. Okay, so and minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 domains are not n pi elements. Okay, take it. So 0, this point will be excluded, pi excluded, minus pi excluded, minus 2 pi excluded, and 2 pi excluded. I'm drawing very small graph. Minus pi by 2 is this line, beyond which it can't go, plus pi by 2, above which also it can't go. And I can accept this as x in between minus pi by 2, maybe somewhere here, plus pi by 2, somewhere here. Minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2. That is all similar to secant inverse secant, but the eyes are shifted down. Okay, so after that it has to come down and you can write sin x as sin pi minus x. So cosecant x as cosecant pi minus x. So it will come down pi minus x. And it will pi minus x will become minus pi by 2 when x is equal to 3 pi by 2. So this one is your 3 pi by 2. Okay, now we have drawn the graph from minus pi by 2 till 3 pi by 2, whose length is 2 pi. So I can simply copy paste this. Okay, and it will go like this, etc., etc. So in simple terms, again this graph is like this only. Only thing is it is extended from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Earlier it was from 0 to pi. That's all. If you want the equations, yeah. This is y equal to x, this is y equal to pi minus x, this is y equal to minus x minus pi, and this is y equal to rising line x plus 2 pi. So alternatively the branches are having a slope of plus 1 and minus 1, even for secant inverse secant x also. So these are the basic graphs of sin inverse sine, cos inverse cos, tan inverse tan, cot inverse cot, secant inverse secant, cosecant inverse cosecant. Okay, so let us do some questions related to this. Okay students, let us do these 4 questions based on the theory we have discussed so far. First one is find tan inverse tan 4 pi by 3. Second one, tan inverse tan minus 24 pi by 3 plus cot inverse cos 26 plus pi by 5. Cot inverse cot 26 pi by 5. Third one, prove that cos of, actually IIT question, cos of tan inverse sine of cot inverse x equal to root over 1 plus x square upon 2 plus x square. And fourth one, simplify tan inverse cot theta plus cot inverse tan theta when theta belongs to pi by 2 to pi. Okay, so you can pause the video for about 15 minutes and you can work out these. Okay, I'm going to discuss the solutions now. You can check with them. The first one, tan inverse tan 4 pi by 3. 4 pi by 3, if you see, it's a standard angle. So the best way is always, whenever there is a standard angle, evaluate that. Tan of 240 degrees, that is like tan of, you know, 180 plus 60, that is tan 60, that is like tan inverse root 3, that is equal to 60. Suppose you want to do the graph with tan inverse tan, you know, y equal to x, excluding these two, 4 pi by 3. So this is like pi by 2. Set of parallel lines, I told you. Yeah, 240. So this is 270. So somewhere here, this is 180. So somewhere here, 4 pi by 3 will be present. And this equation is y equal to x minus pi. Therefore, when x equal to 4 pi by 3, your y equal to 4 pi by 3 minus pi, which is again pi by 3. That is through graph. I mean, what if it is not a standard angle, you have to locate in which interval it will lie and accordingly which branch you have to take and in which branch you have to substitute the x value. But it is a standard angle, so we have simply evaluated the value. Second one, tan inverse tan minus 24 pi by 13. It's not a standard angle, you can use the graph. But I would prefer to first eliminate the negative sign as much as possible. So tan inverse tan minus 24 pi by 13. So we are going to write this as tan inverse of tan minus theta minus tan theta, tan inverse minus theta is minus tan inverse theta. So tan of 24 pi by 13, I will exclude a pi, I will remove a pi from it, because tan of theta minus pi is minus tan of pi minus theta, that is equal to, you know, tan theta. Alternatively, pi is the fundamental period of tan, so we can add it or subtract it. Okay, so I have done that. And then cot inverse cot, 26 pi by 5, more than 5 pi, I will exclude say 4 pi from theta. Can do that. So minus tan inverse tan 13, so 11 by pi by 13, plus cot inverse cot 6 pi by 5. Still 6 pi by 5 is more than pi, so I'll exclude one more pi from this. And this one, if you see 11 pi by 13, your comparison should be with pi by 2, 1 by 2.5, so it's more than that. So what we have to do, we locate it, okay? And okay, let us locate these two on the graph. So this is y equal to x again, from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and this is 3 pi by 2, this is pi. So 11 pi by 13, slightly less than pi, 11 pi by 13. Okay, so that is more than pi by 2, so it will fall into this branch. This branch is y equal to x minus pi. So tan inverse tan 11 pi by 13 equal to 11 pi by 13 x minus pi. So that is minus 2 pi by 13. Got it? Cot 6 pi by 5. Pi plus pi by 5, if you write, for example, this one. So cot inverse cot pi plus pi by 5, that is nothing but cot inverse cot pi by 5, that is equal to pi by 5. And there is a negative sign here, so our final answer is negative of this negative plus 2 pi by 13 plus pi by 5. Take LCM 65, 10 plus 23. 10 plus 13, that is 23 pi by 65. That is your final answer. Okay. So, third one. It's a regular routine problem. Okay. So, whenever you see such a big expression from left to right, all you have to do is to evaluate it from right to left. That is the innermost argument for theta mon log. Alpha, beta, theta, jo bhi. So, let cot inverse x is theta, immediately theta lies between 0 to pi. Okay, so x equal to cot theta. Then question is cos of tan inverse sine of theta. Ye kya hai? Theek hai? Iska triangle banayenge, cot theta x by 1, aur ye hua root 1 plus x square. Aapko chahiye kya? Sine theta. So that is like cos of tan inverse sine theta. Sine theta is 1 by root 1 plus x square. Abhi bhi ek aur tan inverse hai andar, to isko maan lo alpha. That is, let tan inverse 1 by root 1 plus x square equal to alpha. Alpha belongs to minus, you need not say minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, because 1 by root 1 plus x square is a positive quantity. So preferably you can write it lies between 0 to pi by 2. So tan alpha is basically 1 by root 1 plus x square. Now my question simply becomes cos of alpha. Okay, tan alpha, you have make a triangle. Alpha 1, 1 plus x square, 1, 2 plus x square. So cos alpha kya hai? Dekho, root 1 plus x square by root 2 plus x square. That's all. And the last one, tan inverse cot theta, cot inverse tan theta. See, we have discussed tan inverse tan theta. Okay. So, we have to convert this in terms of tan. So, I am going to write this as tan inverse tan 90 minus theta. For example, cot inverse cot 90 minus theta. So that what will happen? Theta belongs to pi by 2 to pi. We will ensure that pi by 2 minus theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to 0. So, pi by 2 minus theta is an angle that lies between minus pi by 2 to 0. So we'll take the graph of tan inverse tan cot inverse cot in minus pi by 2 to 0. Tan inverse tan theta, for example. Okay, this is 0, this is pi by 2 excluded. This is minus pi by 2. So when minus pi by 2 to 0, it is still y equal to x, or tan inverse tan x, for example. This is x axis. So tan inverse tan x is basically y equal to x when x belongs to minus pi by 2 to 0. Therefore, I can say that tan inverse, what you have written here, tan pi by 2 minus theta is exactly equal to pi by 2 minus theta, because theta belongs to pi by 2 to pi, yani pi by 2 minus theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to 0, which is well within the range of tan inverse. Graph is also not required. Okay, cot inverse cot. Cot inverse cot open 0 to pi. Okay. And the domain, if you see, n pi, okay, even this is excluded, pi excluded, minus pi excluded. So that is y equal to x between 0 to pi. So this is pi, okay. So y equal to x completely, there only. And again, yeah, at minus pi also, it is excluded. So this is pi by 2 minus, and this is plus pi by 2, peak is a plus pi by 2. So that is cot inverse, cot is graph. The branch is lies between minus pi by 2 to 0. In minus pi by 2 to 0, as you can see, it is y equal to minus x, y equal to minus x. Wait, how come it is y equal to minus x? Sorry. तो ये वापस एडिट करना है, करना है, करना है। ये पावर है इसका। ओके, कमिंग बैक टू कॉट इनवर्स कॉट, कॉट इनवर्स कॉट थीटा, इफ यू सी, दिस इज कॉट इनवर्स कॉट एक्स व्हेन एक्स बिलोंग्स टू जीरो टू पाई, सो दिस इज जीरो सी. And this is a pi. This is again pi. 0 to pi. Excluded. Excluded. Again parallel straight line. Excluded. Excluded. So as you can see, this is minus pi by 2. In minus pi by 2 to 0, the branch is still this branch, and this branch is y equal to x plus pi. So therefore, cot inverse cot something, when that something lies between minus pi by 2 to 0, is that something plus pi. So this plus pi, that is 3 pi by 2 minus theta. Therefore, final answer to my question is equal to pi by 2 minus theta plus pi by 2 minus theta plus pi. That is like pi, pi, 2 pi, 2 pi minus 2 theta. Okay? That depends on. तो वापस करेंगे.
आप करोगे आप?
हम करेंगे. Okay students, let us discuss more properties. These are the properties. Cos inverse root 1 minus x square equal to sin inverse x when x belongs to 0 to 1 minus sin inverse x when x belongs to minus 1 to 0. Most important ones: sin inverse x plus cos inverse x equal to pi by 2 when x belongs to minus 1 to 0. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x equal to pi by 2 when x is any real number. Secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x equal to pi by 2 when x belongs to the domain minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. And lastly, very good exam question or a property: tan inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by x equal to pi by 2 if x is positive minus pi by 2 if x is negative. I would like to ask you to pause here and try by yourself how to do this. Okay, anyway, I'm going to discuss the solutions now, so you can recheck your answers. Let us start with the first one. Alright, So we have to connect cos inverse root 1 minus x square along with sin inverse x. So what we can do? Let us first assume that sin inverse x equal to theta. Clearly it lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Implies x equal to sin theta. Therefore, cos inverse root 1 minus x square will become cos inverse root 1 minus sin square theta, that is cos inverse root cos square theta, that is cos inverse, not cos theta. We are supposed to write mod cos theta. But theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Therefore, mod cos theta is cos theta, because cos theta is positive in minus 90 to 90. So that is going to be like cos inverse cos theta. Now if you see the graph of cos inverse cos theta, right? This is minus pi, 0 and then pi. Cos inverse cos theta. In 0 to 90, it is y equal to x. In minus 90 to 0, it is y equal to minus x. Therefore, I am going to write this as theta if theta goes from 0 to 90, and minus theta if theta goes from minus 90 to 0. Alright? Therefore, this is going to be sin inverse x if theta, sin inverse x goes from 0 to 90, that means x belongs to 0 to 1, minus theta, minus sin inverse x, if theta belongs to minus 90 to 0, sin theta belongs to minus 1 to 0, that is x belongs to minus 1 to 0. Okay? The second one, four interesting properties, sin inverse x plus cos inverse x. You want to simplify this. What is this? When x belongs to minus 1 to 1. Let us start with any one of them. Let us assume, for example, cos inverse x equal to theta automatically belongs to 0 to pi. That means x equal to cos theta. So we have sin inverse x, which is cos theta, plus cos inverse x, which is simply theta. That is sin inverse sin 90 minus theta plus theta. And you see theta belongs to 0 to pi. So 90 minus theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So effectively, it fits into the range of sin inverse. Okay, so I can straight away write it as pi by 2 minus theta, and then there is plus theta gone, and you get pi by 2. You can prove the same result using calculus also. Okay, assuming this as f of x, differentiate, you will get 0. F dash is 0 for every x, means fx is a constant. To get the value of constant, you can put any known value, x equal to 0 or x equal to 1. Then you get that is equal to pi by 3. But here we are in trigonometry, so yeah, we'll do like that. Similarly, the second one, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x equal to pi by 3. How to prove that? Same thing, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. Let us again assume cot inverse x equal to theta, that belongs to open 0 to pi. So which means x is cot theta, of course. Then tan inverse cot theta plus theta. Tan inverse tan 90 minus theta plus theta. Again, theta belongs to 0 to pi. 90 minus theta belongs to minus 90 to plus 90, which is again within the range of this. So I can simply write it as like that, and I get pi by 2. Similarly, third proof follows. Okay, follows here. And the last one, tan inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by x. I think we have already discussed in 1 by x properties, but again, let us do afresh. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by x. So let us start with tan inverse x equal to theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Please make this as a practice. Whenever you put any inverse equal to theta, please note that the theta belongs to range of that particular inverse. Okay, so x equal to tan theta, where theta belongs to again minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So my question is now, tan inverse x plus tan inverse, you know, 1 by x, that is equal to, you see, that is tan inverse x, which is theta, plus tan inverse 1 by x, which is 1 by tan theta, that is theta, plus tan inverse cot theta, that is theta, plus tan inverse tan 19 minus theta. Now you see, this is like theta plus 90 minus theta. My theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So 90 minus theta belongs to 0 to pi. And if you see tan inverse tan graph, tan x graph for example, okay, excluding, sorry, this is a set of parallel lines y equal to x, excluding the bound n points from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. And I want in 0 to pi, so I have to extend here, say this is 3 pi by 2 and this is pi, yeah, this is pi. So in 90 to pi, that is one thing, and in 0 to 90, that is one thing. This branch name is y equal to x and this branch is y equal to x minus pi. So because of that, okay, I can say that this is y equal to x, pi by 2 minus theta, if that pi by 2 minus theta fits in 0 to pi by 2, and that is equal to x minus pi. So x minus pi, if, of course there is this theta also is there, okay, theta plus this, okay, if that pi by 2 minus theta fits in this interval pi by 2 open to pi closed. So as you can see, these two are gone, these two are gone. So it is simply pi by 2. If pi by 2 minus theta belongs to 0 to 90, that is theta belongs to 0 to pi by 2 open. And this is minus pi by 2 minus pi, the minus pi by 2, if theta belongs to, you know, pi by 2 to pi. Theta belongs to 0 to 90, tan theta belongs to 0 to infinity, that is x greater than 0. This is if x less than 0. Okay? Okay students, so these are the some problems based on the theory discussed so far. Okay, you can pause the video, try the questions. They should ideally take about 1 hour to complete all these problems, and then you can come again to check the solutions. Okay, so the questions are: solve tan of secant inverse 1 by x is sine of tan inverse 2. Solve this also, step of sin inverse x greater than step of cos inverse x, step is greatest integer function. Third one is find minimum maximum values of these expressions. There are about 6 parts for here. Sin inverse x into cos inverse x, sin inverse x whole square plus whole square, sin inverse x whole cube plus cos inverse x whole cube, sin inverse x whole square minus cos inverse x whole square, sin inverse x upon cos inverse x, 2 by sin inverse x plus cos inverse x the whole square. And this one, find range. Again same, minimum maximum values. In tan inverse x into cot inverse x, cosecant inverse x into secant inverse x, tan inverse x whole square plus cot inverse x whole square, tan inverse x whole cube plus cot inverse x whole cube. Okay, so these are the questions, try them. I'll discuss the solutions so you can compare them, your answers. Okay, okay students, let us discuss the solutions. The first one, tan of secant inverse 1 upon x is sine of tan inverse 2. Okay, so let us simplify this first. Suppose this is theta, tan inverse 2 is theta, means 2 equal to tan theta. So this will become sin theta, tan theta 2 hai, so sin theta 2 upon root 5 hai. Okay, so ultimately you have to solve karna hai ki tan of secant inverse x, 1 upon x of course, equal to 2 upon रूट इसको सॉल्व करना है. ओके सो सपोज दिस इज अल्फा लेट सेकेंड इनवर्स 1 अपॉन एक्स इक्वल अल्फा इंप्लाइज टैन अल्फा इक्वल टू 2 बाय रूट 5. ठीक है तो अल्फा का ट्रायंगल यहां बनाएंगे 2 एन अल्फा इक्वल टू 2 अपॉन रूट 5. तो सेकेंड इनवर्स 1 अपॉन एक्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ 1 अपॉन एक्स सो दैट इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू कॉस इनवर्स एक्स दैट इज इक्वल टू अल्फा यानी एक्स इक्वल टू कॉस अल्फा एंड यू कैन सी कॉस अल्फा इज रूट 5 अपॉन 1 देयरफॉर फाइनली एक्स इक्वल टू रूट 5. ओके that is about first one. The second way, root 5 is the answer for the first one. Second one, very important, step of sin inverse x greater than step of cos inverse x. So we are going to plot the graphs of first sin inverse x, cos inverse x. This is 1, this is minus 1, this is like pi by 2. This is like minus pi by 2. So this is sin inverse x graph and the cos inverse x graph we know is this minus 1 plus 1. Okay. So that is cos inverse x graph. How to plot step of a function when the function graph is known? For example, sin inverse x graph we have. We want to plot step of sin inverse x graph. Remember step function definition. Greatest integer less than or equal to x. It is always an integer. So what we are going to do is by looking at this sin inverse x, if you see the range, it lies between minus pi by 2, that is like minus 1.5 to 1.5. Simple strategy is to count the number of integers in this range. So there will be one integer minus 1, there will be one integer plus 1. So this will happen, this will be 1, sin inverse x equal to 1, yani x equal to sin 1. So sin 1 either rahega. Similarly, this is minus 1 when x equal to minus sin 1. Okay, so agar hum dekha jaye ki ye 1 ke upar iska range tab hoga jab x goes from sin 1 to 1. That means in the interval between sin 1 to 1, my sin inverse x is more than 1 but less than pi by 2, 1.5. So uska step jo hai, yahan koi bhi value aap le lo, to uska step hamesha kitna hota hai? 1. So that is y equal to 1 graph, including both the ends. Now below this, between 0 to sin 1, the value is now lies between 0 and 1, whose step is 0. So that is y equal to 0, excluding this. Similarly, between 0 and minus sin 1, it is y equal to minus 1, excluding this. Please note this. On the negative side, what is happening? Between minus sin 1 and minus 1, the value, the value of sin inverse x is between minus 1 and minus 1.5. Minus 1.5 to minus 1. So, which is less than minus 1. Okay, the value lies between minus 1.5 to minus 1. Whose all step excluding minus 1 is minus 2. So, yahan se yahan tak ye hoga. Kya? Minus 2 excluding this one. So, that is ideally your graph of step of sin inverse x. There is same logic. If you look at step of cos inverse x, this is 0, this is pi by 2, and this is like pi. So there is 1 here, there is 2 here, there is even 3 here. It will become 3 when cos inverse x equal to 3, x equal to cos 3. Like that, you can mark cos 3 here and then cos 2 here, and it will be 1 at cos 1, which is like this cos 1. So as you can see in the graph of step of cos inverse x, okay, The value lies between 3 and pi, between minus 1 and cos 3. So, suppose this is minus 1 and cos 3. So, this is 3, for example, 2, 1. Y equal to 3. This is the graph. This is the graph. Okay? And it lies between 2 and 3. When it goes from cos 3, x goes from cos 3 to cos 2. So, cos 3 to cos 2, it is y equal to 2. Excluding cos 3. ठीक है, थोड़ा सा. And it goes from cos 2 to cos 1. Between cos 2 to cos 1, the value actually lies between 1 and 2. So whose step is 1 till cos 1? Till cos 1. And here it is excluded. Cos 1 पे 1 है, चलेगा. Cos 1 to 1, as you can see, it is between 0 to 1, so it is y equal to 0 graph. So these are the branches of, you know, step of cos inverse x, and these are the branches of step of sin inverse x. Okay, so we want to solve the inequality when these branches are at a greater height compared to this. Step of sin inverse x greater than step of cos inverse x, strictly greater than this implies. As you can see, step of cos inverse is very clearly positive. So this quantity can't be negative. This has to be positive. You need not even look at these branches. Okay, let us compare with 0 to sin 1. 0 to sin 1. And this is 0. Just for comparison, sin 1 and cos 1, which is more? Let us start with tan 1. Tan 1, 1 is more than 1 degree. 1 is approximately 57 degrees, so more than 45 degrees. So tan 1 is more than tan 45, which is 1, which means sin 1 greater than cos 1. So cos 1 se jyada hai sin 1, sin 1 idhar rahega maan lo. Okay, sin 1 jyada hai, to cos 1 idhar rahega. Aap dekh sakte ho, 0 to cos 1 mein iska value 0 hai, step of sin inverse ka. और इसका वैल्यू क्या है? 1 है. सो दैट डजंट सेटिस्फाई आवर इनइक्वालिटी. मूविंग ऑन, cos 1 टू sin 1, इसका वैल्यू अभी भी 0 है. cos 1 टू sin 1, इसका वैल्यू भी 0 है, लेकिन यहां इक्वल टू सिंबल नहीं है, तो वो भी एक्सक्लूडेड है. बियॉन्ड sin 1 अगर जाए, sin 1 टू 1, sin 1 टू 1, इसका वैल्यू 1 है, sin 1 टू 1, इसका वैल्यू 0 है. देयरफॉर माय x बिलोंग्स टू स्टेप ऑफ sin 1 टू. Okay, both are included. So that is how you solve these inequalities. In fact, better to plot on the same xy axis, but you have to use multiple colors. Okay, if it is less than, then you can include the negative side also, but our inequality is only for greater than. So this should be your answer. Please note, these type of questions are very important. Plotting step of f of x when a function graph is given. All you have to do is first plot the y equal to fx graph and look at the y-axis, what is the range, and identify all the integers which are present there. At every integer, you draw a horizontal line and see where it cuts the given graph. Effectively, what are the values of x at which that function is going to attain this particular integer? Once you mark all these, okay, then integer to integer, when will this lie between 2 and 3? This graph is going to lie between 2 and 3 when x goes from, for example, alpha to beta. So throughout alpha to beta, since it lies between open 2 to 3, y equal to, step equal to 2. So y equal to 2 line you will draw from alpha to beta. Like that you have to repeat for every interval. So that is about answer to this question. Third and fourth, it is all about finding the ranges of these expressions. Okay, so you must have studied in finding range of any function. There are various methods, simple perfect square greater than or equal to 0, or AMJM inequalities, or differentiation methods, you know, likewise. Let us see what are the things to be used. Okay, third one, come first. very simple expression, sin inverse x into cos inverse x.
Just now we have studied sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is always equal to pi by 2.
I'm going to make use of that. Let cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2 minus sin inverse x. So the expression simply becomes sin inverse x into pi by 2 minus sin inverse x. Now I am going to put sin inverse x as some theta that lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So the expression will be in terms of theta. Let us call it as f of theta. And f of theta is theta into pi by 2 minus theta, provided theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, which is nothing but a quadratic graph. Theta into pi by 2 minus theta, whose roots are 0 pi by 2. And leading quotient negative minus theta square plus theta into pi by 2. You can literally plot the graph. Roots are at 0, pi by 2. Since leading quotient is negative, minus x square plus 2x, something like that. So it will open downwards. So vertex is at the middle point, which is pi by 4. At pi by 4, if you see its value, theta equal to pi by 4 implies, you can also do completing perfect square, but okay, this would be better. Theta equal to pi by 4, pi square value of the pi square by 16 plus pi square by 8. That is pi square by 16. So that is the peak value, pi square by 16, and the graph of the parabola will be something like this. But we don't want the entire range. My theta only goes from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So suppose this is minus pi by 2. Let us evaluate that particular value. Okay, at pi by 2 it is 0. Okay, so when theta equal to minus pi by 2, my f of theta will be, it's my minus pi by 2 put correct. So minus pi square by 4 minus pi square by 4. So that is minus pi square by 2. तो ये जो वैल्यू आएगा आपको माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई टू, यहाँ से लेके आपको बस यहाँ तक, ये जो स्केच किया है सिर्फ उतना रेंज में आपको देखना है. ठीक है, तो इस रेंज में इस ग्राफ का सबसे मिनिमम वैल्यू माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई टू है और सबसे मैक्सिमम वैल्यू जीरो नहीं है, वो इधर है और वो क्या है, पाई स्क्वायर बाई 16. देयरफॉर द रेंज ऑफ द फंक्शन इज इक्वल टू माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई टू टू पाई स्क्वायर बाई 16. तो मिनिमम वैल्यू माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई टू है, वो कहाँ मिलेगा, यहाँ मिलेगा जब थीटा इक्वल टू माइनस पाई बाई टू यानी एक्स इक्वल टू माइनस वन, और मैक्सिमम वैल्यू मिलेगा कितना, पाई स्क्वायर बाई 16. दैट इज पार्ट वन. पार्ट टू, साइन इनवर्स एक्स का होल स्क्वायर प्लस कॉस इनवर्स एक्स का होल स्क्वायर. नाउ बोथ आर पॉजिटिव क्वांटिटीज, राइट? वी नो साइन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस कॉस इनवर्स एक्स इक्वल टू पाई बाई टू, सो यू कैन एक्सप्रेस इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ दैट ऑल्सो and work out the problem. But okay, I'll follow the same method. You can't use RMS, because RMS, if you want to use, you have to take mod sin inverse mod cos inverse, then you can apply RMS greater than a. okay, but there is no mod here. Okay, now I'm going to follow the exactly same procedure, right? Second problem, sin inverse x ka whole square plus cos inverse x ka whole square. Let cos inverse x equal to t that belongs to, you know, 0 to pi. I'm working in terms of cos inverse. Then sin inverse x will be written as pi by 2 minus t. ठीक है? तो the question will be in terms of, you know, t, pi by 2 minus t ka whole square plus t square. If you simplify, t square, 2 t square minus 2ab pi t plus pi square by 4. That is 2 into t square. I'm doing slightly differently by completing perfect square method. This is going to be like 2 into t minus pi by 4 ka whole square minus 1 by 16, 2 by 16 plus 1 by 16. Okay, so this is your graph f of t, which is definitely greater than or equal to pi square by, as you can see, ye hamesha greater than or equal to 0 hai. So this is always greater than or equal to pi square by 8. Okay, a least value occurs if at this equal to 0, yani t equal to pi by 4, that is x equal to 1 by root. Ab humko chahiye greatest value. Greatest value agar dekha jaye, t belongs to 0 to pi, एंड ये ग्राफ क्या है, टी माइनस पाई बाई फोर होल स्क्वायर प्लस पाई स्क्वायर बाई 16 इनटू 2. सपोज इसको वाई मानते हैं तो ये होगा ऐसा कि टी माइनस पाई बाई फोर होल स्क्वायर इक्वल टू वाई बाई 2 माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई 16 यानी वाई 1 बाई 2 इनटू यू नो पाई स्क्वायर बाई 8. तो इट इज लाइक मोर ऑफ अ पैराबोला.
x minus a whole square equal to 4b into y minus b, our favorite coordinate geometry,
right? So pi by 4 is somewhere here and pi square by 8 suppose is somewhere here, okay? And when x equal to 0, pi square by 16 plus pi into 2, pi square by 8 plus pi square by 8, so that is pi square by 4. Yaha cut karega. तो ये जो पैराबोला आपको मिलेगा ये ऐसा जाएगा, ठीक है, समथिंग लाइक दिस. बट यू सी माय एक्स आर टी व्हाटएवर हियर दैट रेंज इज बिटवीन 0 टू पाई. आई डोंट वांट दिस ग्राफ, आई वांट ओनली फ्रॉम 0 से लेकर पाई. पाई पे इसका वैल्यू कितना है वो एवेल्युएट करेंगे, एफ ऑफ पाई जो है इसमें या इसमें जो भी है इसमें पुट करेंगे 2 * पाई स्क्वायर माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाय 2 प्लस पाई स्क्वायर बाय 8. तो ये होगा 1 by 2, 4 by 8, 1 by 8, 5 by 8, 5 by 4, pi square. 5 by 4, pi square. तो मतलब इससे बहुत बड़ा value है, somewhere here, 5 by 4, pi square यहाँ रहेगा, तो ये आपका pi है. तो ये जो graph है, यहाँ से यहाँ है, इसका minimum value मिला pi square by 8 इधर, और maximum value मिला इधर, pi square by 4. तो therefore आप बोल सकते हो कि रेंज ऑफ योर फंक्शन इज पाई स्क्वायर बाय 8 से लेकर 5 पाई स्क्वायर बाय 4 तक, ठीक है. अगेन मतलब कंप्लीटिंग परफेक्ट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 अगेन ए क्यू प्लस बी क्यू फॉर्मेट. ओके सो आई एम गोइंग टू फर्स्ट राइट इट एज साइन इनवर्स एक्स का होल क्यूब प्लस कॉस इनवर्स एक्स का होल क्यूब. ए क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब वी कैन राइट एज ए प्लस बी इनटू और ए प्लस बी का होल क्यूब माइनस 3 ए बी माइनस 3 ए बी इनटू ए प्लस बट दिस इज पाई बाय 2 तो पाई बाय 2 का होल क्यूब माइनस 3 साइन इनवर्स एक्स कॉस इनवर्स एक्स इनटू अगेन पाई बाय 2. So that is pi cube by 8 minus 3. Suppose sine inverse x equal to t that belongs to minus 90 to 90. Then this is 3t into pi by 2 minus t into pi by 2. So your function of t now becomes pi cube by 8 minus 3 pi by 2t plus 3t square into pi by 2. So there is pi square by 4 and there is into pi by 2. Looks very complicated. Okay, I'll take 3 pi by 2 common. 3 pi by 2. इधर से common लेंगे throughout the expression. Then it is t square, just to make the leading coefficient as one of the quadratic. Minus 2 by 3 pi by 2. 3 pi गया, pi गया, तो pi t by 2. Plus pi cube by 8. 2 by 4 by 3 pi. 2 by 3 pi. By 3, 12, pi pi square, ठीक है. So that is 3 pi by 2 into t minus pi by 4 का whole square 1 by minus 1 by 16, 1 by 12 minus 1 by 16, like 48, right? 4 minus 3, 1 by 48. Okay, so 1 by 48 pi square. So that is completing perfect square. उसके बाद तो normally parabola है ना? तो इसका वर्टेक्स होगा अगर मान लो इसको y तो ये y 2y by 3 pi minus pi square by 48 is x minus pi by 4 का होल स्क्वायर विच कैन बी रिटन एज 2 by 3 pi into y minus 3 pi pi cube by 16 32. Alright, so pi by 4 pi cube by 32. That is the vertex pi cube by 32. Either vertex over when x equal to 0, pi square by 16, 3 by 16, 4 by pi square by 16, 3 by 48, 4 by 1 by 12, 1 by 12, 1 by 21 by 8, pi cube by 8. Pi cube by 8 is where it cuts x-axis, so it is all about plotting it. And this is the parabola. I want from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So minus pi by 2 इधर होगा, pi by 2 इधर होगा मान लो, तो यहाँ से यहाँ तक हम इसका ग्राफ स्केच करेंगे. तो अभी हमको चाहिए minus pi by 2 पे इसका वैल्यू क्या क्या होगा. तो वो हम एवेल्यूएट करेंगे यहाँ. ठीक है, तो f of t मेरे पास है ना, f of minus pi by 2 अगर चाहिए तो वो होगा 3 pi by 2 minus pi by 2 minus pi by 4 minus pi by 2 minus pi by 4 का होल स्क्वायर प्लस pi स्क्वायर by 48. So that is equal to 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 9 by 16, 27 by 48, 28 by 48, 28 by 48, 7 by 12, 7 by 12 into 21 by 7 by 12, 7 by 8 pi cube. F of pi by 2 अगर देखेंगे तो pi by 2 वो होगा 3 pi by 2 into pi by 2 minus pi by 4, that is pi by 4 square, 1 by 16, 3 by 48, 4 by 48, 1 by 12, 1 by 12 is like 1 by 8 pi cube. तो 1 by 8 pi cube. ये ठीक है. So these are the values. So ये होगा 1 by 8 pi cube इधर, और ये होगा 7 by 8 pi cube. So that is much higher level. So maybe 7 by 8 pi cube यहाँ रहेगा. तो ये ग्राफ जो है, इस ग्राफ का लीस्ट वैल्यू मिलेगा आपको यहाँ कहाँ, पाई बाई फोर पे. पाई बाई फोर क्या है, टी का वैल्यू. टी क्या है, आपका साइन इनवर्स एक्स, मतलब एक्स इक्वल टू साइन पाई बाई फोर, एक्स इक्वल टू वन बाई टू. यहाँ इतना लीस्ट वैल्यू मिलेगा और ग्रेटेस्ट वैल्यू माइनस पाई बाई टू पे मिलेगा. देयरफॉर आप बोल सकते हो रेंज ऑफ द फंक्शन इज पाई क्यूब बाई 32 से लेकर कहाँ तक, 7 बाई 8 पाई क्यूब तक. This is the least value, that is the greatest value. Okay, now question number 4. Sin inverse x whole square minus cos inverse x whole square. Okay, so that can be written as a minus b into a plus b. So that is simply sin inverse x minus cos inverse x into sin inverse x plus cos inverse x, which is pi by 2. So again cos inverse x, you write it as 90 minus sin inverse x. Okay, so that will become 2 sin inverse x. Okay, minus pi by 2 into pi by 2. Now we can work out orally. Sin inverse x lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Twice of sin inverse x lies between, you know, minus pi to pi. Okay, uske baad 2 sin inverse x minus pi by 2 lies between minus 3 pi by 2 to pi by 2 into pi by 2 agar kare. So your f belongs to minus 3 pi square by 4 to pi square by 4. So that is your range, straightforward. Alright? Uske baad. Fifth one. Sin inverse x upon cos inverse x. So let this expression equal to y. Cross multiply. It's more like, you know, rational function. Vaisa wala method use karna hai. तो सबसे इजी होगा. तो y इन टू cos inverse x, इसको लिखेंगे pi by 2 minus sin inverse x, that is equal to sin inverse x. See, I'm always trying to convert in terms of sin inverse x, that is preferred method, because sin inverse is an increasing function, cos inverse x is a decreasing function, inequalities will get reversed. Sin inverse x is increasing function, inequality will be applied as it is. So yeah, तो y pi by 2 equal to y plus 1 into sin inverse x. तो sin inverse x जो है y pi by 2 by y plus 1, and you know sin inverse x must lie between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So I have to solve this inequality y pi by 2 by y plus 1 less than or equal to pi by 2. Cancel pi by 2, y by y plus 1 less than or equal to 1. This is our familiar rational inequality, which is solved using the Weaker method. So y by y plus 1 plus 1 greater than or equal to 0, and at the same time y by y plus 1 minus 1 less than or equal to 0. 2y plus 1 by y plus 1 greater than or equal to 0, and at the same time minus 1 by y plus 1 less than or equal to 0. So if you see Weaker here, minus 1 by 2 minus 1, ठीक है, तो माइनस वन पे डिनोमिनेटर रूट है और ये होगा आपका वेविक कर्व, ये माइनस ये प्लस और ये प्लस ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो, तो वाई बिलोंग्स टू माइनस इंफिनिटी टू माइनस वन यूनियन माइनस वन बाई टू टू इन्फिनिटी, ये इसका सोल्यूशन है, बीच में एन भी है, इंटरसेक्शन लेना पड़ेगा। उसके बाद ये जो है नेगेटिव साइड उधर भेजो तो ये होगा वन बाई वाई प्लस वन ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो, ठीक है, तो ये जो मतलब इसका जरूरत नहीं है, आप सीधा बोल सकते हो y प्लस वन ग्रेटर देन जीरो, y ग्रेटर देन माइनस वन, तो दैट इज y बिलोंग्स टू माइनस वन टू इन्फिनिटी। दोनों का इंटरसेक्शन अगर कैलकुलेट करेंगे लेस देन माइनस वन नहीं चलेगा, ग्रेटर देन माइनस वन और ये, यानी y बिलोंग्स टू माइनस वन बाई टू क्लोज्ड टू इन्फिनिटी, दैट इज योर रेंज ऑफ द एक्सप्रेशन, मीनिंग मिनिमम एंड लीस्ट वैल्यू इज माइनस वन बाई टू, देर इज नो ग्रेटेस्ट वैल्यू because it is unbounded function, okay, for example when this becomes equal to 0, that is tending to infinity, so it can't exactly be equal to 0, okay, that is not permitted, right, that is about question number 5, question number 6, third question number 6, the last part in this is again same thing, 2 pi sin inverse x plus cos inverse x whole square, again I am going to put sin inverse x equal to t, that belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, then my expression in terms of t will be 2 pi t plus pi by 2 minus t ka whole square, so isko agar simplify kare to pi square by 4 plus t square minus pi t hoga, so matlab ye hoga ki pi square by 4 plus t square plus pi t, yani t plus pi by 2 ka whole square, kitna simple hai dekho, t plus pi by 2 का होल स्क्वायर, जबकि t का रेंज हमको पता है माइनस पाई बाई टू पाई बाई, सो देयरफॉर t प्लस पाई बाई टू विल नाउ बिलोंग्स टू 0 टू पाई, और उसका होल स्क्वायर अगर करेंगे तो दैट बिलोंग्स टू यू नो 0 टू पाई स्क्वायर, देयरफॉर रेंज ऑफ द फंक्शन फॉर द लास्ट वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन थर्ड का लास्ट पार्ट इज 0 टू पाई स्क्वायर, ओके। उसके बाद फोर्थ वन सिमिलर मेथड से कैन अप्लाई, फोर्थ का फर्स्ट वन लेट आई एम गोइंग टू डायरेक्टली पुट tan inverse x इक्वल टू थीटा दैट बिलोंग्स टू माइनस पाई बाई टू टू पाई बाई टू एंड f ऑफ थीटा बिकम थीटा इनटू cot inverse x अगेन 90 माइनस tan inverse x सो पाई बाई टू माइनस थीटा अगेन यू ड्रॉ द ग्राफ ऑफ पैराबोला ओनली 0 टू pi बाई टू लीडिंग कोएफिशिएंट नेगेटिव इन बिटवीन pi बाई फोर के मैक्सिमम pi by 4 into pi by 4 is pi square by 16 यहाँ रहेगा, तो ऐसा होगा आपका ग्राफ, लेकिन हमको minus 90 to plus 90 ही चाहिए क्योंकि थीटा का रेंज उतना है, तो यहाँ से लेकर मान लो यहाँ तक, तो f of minus pi by 2 कितना है ये भी कैलकुलेट करो, minus pi by 2 into pi, तो ये होगा minus pi square by 2, तो यानी range of the function is minus pi square by 2 minimum टू ये मैक्सिमम कितना पाई स्क्वायर बाय 16 बस। क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 कोसेकेंट इनवर्स एक्स इनटू सेकेंट इनवर्स एक्स 90 माइनस फॉर एग्जांपल कोसेकेंट इनवर्स एक्स, ठीक है, तो लेट थीटा इक्वल टू अगेन कोसेकेंट इनवर्स एक्स दैट बिलोंग्स टू माइनस पाई बाय 2 टू पाई बाय 2 एक्सक्लूडिंग ऑफ कोर्स 0, then what will happen, my f of theta will simply become theta into pi by 2 minus theta, in same thing, right, 0 pi by 2 at pi by 4 it is pi square by 16, again same graph, but this time again I want from minus pi by 2, so this is like minus pi square by 2, okay, minus pi by 2 into pi, तो यहां से यहां तक वापस जाएगा एक्सक्लूडिंग दिस एलिमेंट 0, थीटा इक्वल टू 0 पे 0, तो देयरफॉर इस बार रेंज क्या होगा, थोड़ा अलग होगा, माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई 2 से लेकर 0 यूनियन 0 से लेकर ये पीक वैल्यू पाई स्क्वायर बाई 60, दैट इज अबाउट सेकंड पार्ट, थर्ड वन tan इनवर्स प्लस cot इनवर्स का होल स्क्वायर, तो यू कैन आल्सो राइट दिस एज for example tan inverse x plus cot inverse x का whole square minus 2 tan inverse x cot inverse x which is pi by 2 square करो तो pi square by 4 minus 2
tan inverse x into cot inverse x.
अभी अभी हमने एक रेंज निकाला था, वापस वही करेंगे. तो ये इंटरवल जाएगा कहाँ से कहाँ तक देखो, माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई 2 से लेकर माइनस प्लस पाई स्क्वायर बाई 16. तो पाई स्क्वायर बाई 4 माइनस 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो ये होगा माइनस पाई स्क्वायर बाई 8 प्लस पाई स्क्वायर. तो अभी इसको ऐड करेंगे ये वाला, तो 2 बाई 1 बाई 8 पाई स्क्वायर बाई 8 एंड 5 बाई 4 पाई स्क्वायर. तो दिस इज द आंसर फॉर 4 का थर्ड. सिमिलरली 4 का फोर्थ, 4 का फोर्थ अगर देखेंगे tan inverse x plus cot inverse x का होल क्यूब माइनस 3 tan inverse x cot inverse x into tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. अब ये तो pi by 2 है, इसका होल क्यूब माइनस 3 tan inverse x cot inverse x into pi by 2. This is pi cube by 8 minus 3 pi by 2 into again tan inverse x into cot inverse x range. वापस डिराइव किया है प्रीवियस से, उसी को मैं यूज करूंगा. तो pi cube by 8 minus 3 pi by 2 into what is that interval, minus pi square by 2 to pi square by 16. ठीक है, तो माइनस 3 पाई बाई 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो ये प्लस होगा, ये माइनस आएगा पहले, माइनस पाई क्यूब 3 बाई 32 और ये बिकम्स प्लस 3 पाई क्यूब बाई 4. इसको पाई क्यूब बाई 8 ऐड करो, 4 बाई 32 1 बाई 32 पाई क्यूब बाई 32. ओके, 6 बाई 8 1 बाई 8 7 बाई 8 पाई क्यूब. सो दिस इज द रेंज फॉर द लास्ट. क्लियर? Okay, so more or less these are simple manipulations. Only thing is we need to remember the basic properties. Sin inverse plus cos inverse is pi by 2. Tan inverse plus cot inverse is pi by 2. Secant inverse plus cosecant inverse is pi by 2. And the corresponding ranges. Sin inverse range, cos inverse range, tan inverse, cot inverse, secant inverse, cosecant inverse range. That's all. And simple quadratic methods, completing perfect square, wave curve, inequalities, etc. Okay, so we'll continue with more properties ahead. Right?